My left eyelid is noticeably drooping. What could be causing this? It hasn't always drooped. Noticed it in the last few months.
Thank you for your question. You submitted a question with a single photo, and you state in your question that your left upper eyelid hasn't always drooped, and it's drooped in the recent past few months. And you're asking what could be causing this. Well, certainly I can share with you how I evaluate a patient who has the onset of a drooping eyelid. Of course, this is in the absence of a proper full examination, but I can give you basically an idea of how I do my evaluation. So, a little bit of background. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years, and dealing with drooping eyelids is part of the practice that we deal with every day. The technical term is called ptosis. So to begin with, I will just say to you that it looks like the left upper lid is drooping to the point where it's blocking significantly the pupil or the center of the eye. But I also noticed that the right upper lid is also relatively low. Now, given what is statistically most likely based on this appearance, essentially we look at ptosis as caused by a muscle problem or a nerve problem. And when we do an evaluation, part of a ptosis evaluation, we look at various things such as the muscle function, and we look at the eye movements, and we look at the pupils, and the center of the eye, the black part of the eye. And most commonly, ptosis, such as yours, is referred to as involutional ptosis or age-related ptosis. Basically, what happens is the muscle that lifts the eyelid is called the levator muscle, like the word elevator. And this muscle, as one gets older, has a tendency to get very thin and may also detach or separate, often referred to as levator dehiscence. Well, the general approach to this is to do a surgical procedure, which means to reattach the muscle or the muscle tendon to the eyelid in a way to get the eyelid to open again. Now, this is a procedure that is deceptively complex. And the reason is that this muscle is very, very tricky to work with. The goal is to achieve the right height, the shape, the symmetry, and get the most aesthetic result. In our practice, we routinely do these surgeries in our office operating facility, and we'll actually have the patient sit up during the surgery to measure and make sure that the eyes are even and they look good. And so that is what is most likely the cause based on my experience. Now, when I do see a patient who I wonder if there is other variables and I want a possible neurologic perspective, I will refer the patient to a neuro-ophthalmologist. And this is an ophthalmologist who not only did a residency in eye surgery, but did fellowship training in the neurology as it relates to the eyes. So a neuro-ophthalmologist may be consulted in my practice to at least make sure that there is no other cause for the ptosis. So you really have to differentiate the muscle cause of the ptosis from a neurologic cause. So I think it's important for you to meet with qualified, experienced doctors. You can start with either an oculofacial plastic reconstructive surgeon or a neuro-ophthalmologist and get an understanding of what the situation is. A lot of times, ophthalmologists tend not to deal with these particular problems that often and will end up referring you out anyway. So that's why I'm making that suggestion about seeing an oculoplastic doctor or a neuro-ophthalmologist. At least you can get an understanding of what the cause is so that you can take the appropriate steps. If the cause is the muscle, then surgery is usually the best option. If it's more of a neurologic issue, then you need a proper workup to figure out what the underlying cause is so that can be addressed appropriately. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.